and we run it back in October. Good luck to Oleksandr. Well done. God bless you. Happy New Year!
Wait, what? Tyson Fury, one of the sharpest minds in boxing, is saying Happy New Year 5 months late.
Happy New Year!
That's not Fury cracking a joke. That is a red flag. After taking repeated punches to the head, he may have been showing signs of a concussion or a head injury. An injury that sidelined countless fighters and could have ended Fury's career. Here's what happens. A punch to the head shakes your brain, slamming it against the inside of your skull. Neurons get damaged, neurotransmitters go haywire, and your brain hits an energy crash. Suddenly, you're foggy, dizzy, bright lights feel unbearable, and emotionally you're feeling anxious, snappy, and just not yourself. The worry here is life-threatening issues like brain bleeds. That's why if this sounds like you after a fight, you need to get checked out by a doctor. Without a bleed, we recommend resting for 24 to 48 hours with no screens and no heavy thinking. In this video, we're breaking down the injuries that nearly ended Fury's career.
And I've got like some elbow problems that I got to maybe have surgery on my right elbow.
Both elbows is numb. He's since had an operation.
And the brutal toll that boxing takes on the body and brain. I'm Jack, I'm a doctor in the UK, and let's get into this.
Tyson. Tyson is not on the bill tonight because what have you done to yourself?
I've fractured my knuckle in the right hand.
Yes. That happened last week, didn't it?
Last week, yes. Last Saturday. Punched someone on top of the head and here's the result. Idiot, really.
Yes.
This injury is so common in boxing that it's literally called boxer's fracture. Here's how it happens. When you throw a punch, you're supposed to land with the index and middle knuckles. These two bones right here. But if you misjudge your opponent and hit them with the weaker knuckle of your pinky finger, you risk a fracture. A boxer's fracture is the break in the neck of the fifth metacarpal right here. Most heal with a splint or cast in 3 to 6 weeks, but more severe breaks may need surgery. The best way to avoid it is with proper punching technique and padded gloves, because even the best fighters can make mistakes. But it's not just the hands that take a beating. Every punch you throw puts incredible strain on your elbows too. Just ask Tyson Fury.
And I've got like some elbow problems that I got to maybe have surgery on my right elbow.
Both on the right?
Just on the right on. I had the left done back in October after the Wilder 3 fight. So I've got to have it done. It'll take about 6 to 8 weeks to heal.
Tyson was very badly injured going into that fight. He had to have chromosome injections in both elbows. Both elbows is numb. He's since had an operation. 6 hour all day in the hospital having it sorted out his elbows because I think he had some bone spurs we had to get removed. Common thing in sportsmen, especially boxers. And yeah, he was handicapped from the beginning.
Imagine that, punching so hard, so often that your bones literally start growing extra bones just to keep up. It's called a bone spur, a result of years of repeated impact and hyperextension of your elbows. Your body tries to fix itself by laying down more bone to stabilize the joint, but instead this can cause pain, inflammation, and lock up your joints. For Fury, it wasn't just a nuisance. It was the thing standing between him and a shot at boxing history, an undisputed fight with Oleksandr Usyk. While bone spurs and fractures can stop you from throwing punches, there's another injury that can take away something far more critical. Your sight.
Hey mom, I'm on TV!
What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do the Ray Leonard, one of them, and it's gonna go bang, bang, yeah. Knock him out cold.
That's what I'm talking about.
I say, I might even touch the foot, flick him in the mouth, lean back, right, I've got left hook, flick out, down.
The ball will punch.
Oh, you Ray, alright? Don't pick him Gano over me, Ray.
This is Sugar Ray Leonard, one of the greatest boxers of all time.
I remember I was scheduled to fight this guy in 2 weeks, and I was seeing like someone pull a shade down on my eye. So I went to an ophthalmologist, and they said, if you don't have surgery in a week, you will be blind.
In 1982, after a brutal fight, he almost went blind in his left eye. What was the injury? A detached retina.
Welterweight champion Sugar Ray Leonard underwent eye surgery to repair a detached retina.
Here's how it works. Your eye has a thin layer of tissue at the back called the retina. It's packed with light-sensitive cells that allow you to see. But when you take a hard punch in the eye, that force can cause the retina to either tear or detach, stopping it from sensing the light properly. This leads to symptoms like sudden floaters, those little spots drifting in your vision, flashes of light in your peripheral vision, or a shadow, like a curtain, spreading across your field of view. This is a medical emergency. Without immediate treatment, your vision is on the line. Sugar Ray Leonard needed urgent surgery to save his vision, and while the operation was a success, the risk was too high. At just 26 years old, he retired.
My ophthalmologist said, Ray, if you want to fight again, you can fight again, but the majority of the people wanted me to retire because they said, Ray, you know what, you have fame, you have money, don't risk it.
A punch to the eye might crack the windscreen, but the force behind it shakes your foundation. That foundation is your brain.
He is right there, the guy that inspired me in my journey.
Well, I'd say I'm a modern day Muhammad Ali.
Well, Henry Cooper's nothing but a tramp. He's a bum. I'm the world's greatest.
I'll beat you, you bum. You're a bum.
Muhammad Ali, one of Fury's greatest inspirations, is also a sobering example of the risks that boxers face.
People who don't really know much about me, it'll tell them more about who I am. They'll understand more about the legend of Muhammad Ali.
Ali developed Parkinson's disease in the 1980s, just a few years after he retired. Repeated head trauma over a career is believed to have contributed to the degeneration of his neurons. And Ali's case isn't isolated. Research backs this up too. Cardiff University found that boxers with a history of repeated head trauma developed neurodegenerative diseases like Alzheimer's and Parkinson's up to 5 years earlier than non-boxers. Namfan is believed to be showing symptoms of CTE here.
Hey, how's it going? This is me, Namfan. Just getting done with my morning run. Now I'm getting ready to train at my school, the Madhu Academy.
Yeah, how you doing? Need to get 10 miles morning. Woke up late, but I did run 5 miles. This sounds good.
Chronic traumatic encephalopathy is caused by years of repeated blows to the head and shrinking of the brain. This disrupts the way that the nerve cells can communicate with one another, causing those symptoms. In 2009, a study of 224 retired professional boxers found that 11% showed mild signs of CTE, while 6% showed moderate to severe cases. The symptoms? Aggression, difficulty speaking, and impulsivity. Changes that can wreck lives and careers. The hardest part of this is that CTE can only be diagnosed after death, making prevention the only real solution. It's not just the pros though. Amateur boxing carries real risks too. Studies show that boxers sustain, on average, one injury every 2.4 hours of competition and every 772 hours of training. So what can you do to protect yourself? Limit sparring intensity. It's not about going all out every single time. Recover properly between hard impacts. Seek medical attention for any suspected concussion. And most importantly, follow return to play protocols really strictly. Now, I realize that all of these weren't Tyson Fury's past injuries, but some of those risks he does carry going forward. Every single fight, boxers risk getting a really severe head injury causing a brain bleed. And over time, with all of the repeated head trauma that he's had, he's at risk of these neurodegenerative diseases. So I think it's really important to not just reflect on his previous injuries, but also the risks that boxing poses to the future. Now, if you want to build healthy habits based on evidence-based advice, then that's what I love to do here. So I've got loads coming up in 2025, and I'm really, really excited to share all of those videos with you. So if you want to follow along on this journey, please subscribe and leave a comment below with which injury you would want to sustain the least.